न्यू चैप्टर चैप्टर 6 फॉर्म्स ऑफ बिजनेस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन पार्ट 2 पार्ट 45 इंट्रोडक्शन मीनिंग एंड द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ कोऑपरेटिव सोसाइटी इंट्रोडक्शन सोल प्रोप्रेटरशिप पार्टनरशिप एंड कंपनी आर थ्री फॉर्म्स ऑफ बिजनेस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन फ्रॉम द पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू ऑफ देयर प्राइमरी ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ प्रॉफिट All these three forms can exploit the customers through various means to get profit. Example, providing low quality goods, charging high price, black marketing of goods, etc. Through cooperative society is a form of business organization. It differs from the other forms of business organization due to its special characteristics. Put into execution the slogan, no progress without cooperation. It comes into being with the objective of each for all and all for each. Cooperative society, assembling of persons voluntarily for establishing a union for any common economic interest and objective on equality basis and through services is known as cooperative society. According to James Peter, cooperative society is such a form of business organization wherein individuals interested in achieving common interest unite democratically and the objective behind the production and distribution is not profit but that of a service. Other forms of business is mainly meant for acquiring more and more profit. And all these three forms can exploit the customers through different ways. For removing this and with the consideration of service and attain the common interest of different persons with their cooperation. And based on this idea, a form of business originated. It is known as cooperative society. The main objective is to service other than the motive of profit. Cooperative society meaning. Cooperative society is a voluntary form of business organization wherein persons with a common interest get associated voluntarily. The individuals form a cooperative society to achieve their definite objective. The objective of cooperative society is to promote the economic interest of the members through cooperation among the members. In simple words, the definition of cooperative society is as follows. Cooperative society is a form of business organization in which individuals get associated for the upliftment of their economic interest on equal basis. Cooperative society is voluntary business organization created on the basis of equality of people who have common economic interest created with each others. Support by business self-reliance to improve their economic condition. So, cooperative society is a form of business organization in which individuals get associated or assembled for the upliftment of their economic interest on equal basis. The following are the characteristics of a cooperative society. First one, voluntary association. It is a voluntary association of individuals. Individuals join in the cooperative society on the basis of equality. A person who has a common interest and is prepared to be abide by the rules of the society has the right to join the society as and when he wishes to do so. Continue in it as long as he likes and leave it at his will. On leaving the society, shares are not transferable to other person, although they are automatically transmitted to heirs on the death of a member. It is not compulsory. It is very voluntarily association. Those who are interested, they can join in a cooperative society with common interest. Easy formation process. The formation process of a cooperative society is easier than that of a company. Minimum 10 persons join together and get it registered with the Register of Cooperative Society under Cooperative Society Act. With registration, the society gets a separate legal identity. There is very simple formation procedure for the formation or establishment of cooperative society. When 10 or more members unite together, apply as per Cooperative Societies Act before the Register of Cooperative Society for registration. After the registration, its separate legal entity comes into existence. Equality of members. Members have equal right and equal opportunity in the cooperative society. There is no distinction among the members due to capital investment or for any other reason. Each and every members of the cooperative society have equal status and not based on their capital or their investment. And everyone is considered with the common interest to service and to achieve their common interest. Along with each member have voting right per member. Each member entitled to a single vote regardless of the number of shares held by him. So the equality principle is prevailed in cooperative society. Separate identity. With the registration, the cooperative society gets a legal separate identity from its members. Entry and exit of the member does not affect on its existence. The cooperative society is a cooperative institution registered under Cooperative Societies Act. It has separate legal identity and existence separate from its members. Members may join or retire. It has no effect on the existence of cooperative society. Democratic management. A cooperative society is managed by the representatives elected by the members. In company, voting right is per share, but in the cooperative society, voting right is per member. Significance is not to capital, but significance is given to man in cooperative society. Any member can contest the election of executive committee, can participate in management. The management of the cooperative society is really democratic as compared to a company. Hence, cooperative society is called a training school of democracy. If the members can participate at par in management of cooperative society without a discrimination of community, caste or religion. The working committee decided by the members manages the affairs of the cooperative society in democratic manner. So it is known as cooperative society is called a training school of democracy. Main motive of service. The main objective of cooperative society is to serve members. Profit is a secondary objective. Economic upliftment of the members is through service motive. Cooperative society attempts to raise the living standard of the members and make them self-reliant. Example, the aim of a customer's cooperative society is to provide the goods of proper quality at a fair price. The main purpose of cooperative society is not that of making profit, but is to provide services to members. The prime objective of cooperative society is to achieve economic growth of the members and stop their economic exploitation. Fair distribution of profit. In spite of motto of service, if there is excess of income, the profit is distributed among the members of society subject to the provisions of law. Residual profit is utilized for the welfare of the members of society. Though the objective is that of service, the profit of cooperative society is distributed among the members by way of dividend. The remaining profit is spent for the providing document or gift on purchases to customers, or it is spent for members or social welfare. Low price of share. Persons with a low income can purchase a share and become the member of society. As the price of share of cooperative society is low, sometimes installment facility is also provided to member instead of paying full amount at once. The price of the shares of cooperative society is kept low to be within the reach of poor. the shares of cooperative society are not quoted in the share market. The facility of payment by installment is provided to the members for the purchase of shares. Voting right per member. Each member is entitled to a single vote regardless of the number of shares held by him. Representatives are elected on the basis of the principle of one member, one vote. Conference and training classes are planned to promote equality and brotherhood and to add knowledge among the members. In cooperative society, voting right is per member, not based on their shares. The member having any number of shares can give a single vote only. Separate institution from politics and religion. Membership of cooperative society is open to all, irrespective of religion, caste, and sex. A cooperative society cannot exist on the political or religion principle. Thus, cooperative society is separate from the politics and religion. Apart from being voluntary in nature, the membership of cooperative organization is open to all, irrespective of race, color, creed, caste, or sex, and political views, etc. Within that particular group, no distinction can be made on the basis of race, color, creed, caste, sex, or religion, or political parties. The cooperative society is kept detached from the religion and politics. Unrestricted number of members. There is no restriction on the numbers of members so that as many person as possible can become members of the society for their economic upliftment. But minimum 10 number of members is essential to establish a cooperative society. Maximum number of members is not mentioned. So, many persons are possible can become members of the society for their economic welfare and upliftment of their common interest. In this part, we discussed about introduction to cooperative society, meaning and characteristics of a cooperative society.